Welcome back to EDU in 90. On this episode, we'll be focusing on the Explore feature within Google Docs. Some of you might not be familiar with this by name yet, but you've likely noticed it in the bottom right-hand corner within Docs.
That's right. You can access Explore functionality through that small icon or via the Tools section of the top menu bar in Docs. What can you do with Explore? Let's find out. If you're anything like me, you're probably guilty of having way too many tabs and windows open on your computer at any given time. And it can sometimes be tough to keep track of files and information.
The Explore tool in Docs helps you avoid wasting time by allowing you to search the web, images, and your own Google Drive, all from inside your Doc. Crafting compelling presentations and lesson plans takes time and energy, but Explore can help you to save time and focus on what matters most.
In this Doc, I'm creating a chemistry lab safety activity. To access the Explore feature, I can select the icon in the bottom right or choose Explore from the Tools drop-down menu.
With Explore in Docs, you'll get instant suggestions based on the content in your document, whether you're creating a lesson on Tasmania or planning your school's next field trip to Stonehenge. Explore recommends related topics to learn about and images to insert.
And we know that it's often helpful to refer to other files when writing a lesson or creating documentation. That's why we've also made it easy to find a related document from Drive right in Explore. Less time spent switching between apps and tabs means more time to polish your ideas. Now, let's get back to that chemistry lab safety activity and take a closer look at exactly how this works. Now that I've clicked into Explore, it's automatically scanned the content of my doc to provide some suggestions of useful resources, like the lab manual I'd created for an earlier class. For this activity, we're learning about lab safety, and I'd like to include an example image. So in Explore, I can search NFPA hazard and pull an image into my doc. And if I want to do a bit of extra research, I can click into the web tab for some quick results to check out. Explore functionality is also available in Sheets and Slides, and we've included some information on that below. Give it a try and let us know in the comments below how you've used it.
Be sure to subscribe to the Google for Education YouTube channel for more EDU in 90. We'll see you next time.
Check out our last episode where we look at several new features for quizzes and Google Forms.